evening. It's great to see your smiling faces as we gather to celebrate the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We thank you for following the protocols. No significant changes, and our opening hymn will be Table of Plenty, found on your song sheet. Together this evening to give God our thanks and praise in this celebration of the Mass, let us pause a few moments, aware of the presence of Jesus among us now, and together as God's people, let us pray for the grace to be open to his presence, while at the same time, together let us acknowledge our sin, seeking God's mercy, to prepare ourselves to encounter Jesus once again in these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are gracious and merciful. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are compassionate to all and forgiving. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are near to all who call on you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give thanks for your
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread? Your wages, what fails to satisfy. Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew you with the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus heard of the death of John the Baptist, he withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. The crowds heard of this and followed him on foot from their towns. When he disembarked, he saw the vast crowd. His heart was moved with pity for them, and he cured the sick. It was evening, and the disciples approached him, said, "This is a deserted place, and it is already late. Dismiss the crowd so they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "There is no need for them to go away. Give them some food yourselves." But they said to him, "Five loaves and two fishes are all we have here." Then he said, "Bring them here to me." And he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Then taking the loaves and the two fish and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. And they picked up the fragments left over, 12 wicker baskets full. Those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. The gospel, the good news of the Lord.
They need not go away. You give them something to eat. Sounds a bit harsh, doesn't it? From Jesus. You know, it's evening time, and the need that arises, seems every evening, is the need for food. And the disciples have a way of meeting that need. They dismiss the crowds so that they can go buy some food for themselves. They're in a deserted place. Seems like a reasonable proposal, as the markets will soon close. It recognizes the scarcity of food in the desert, so they must go somewhere else and buy it from others. But Jesus powerfully confronts their proposals by saying, They need not go away. You give them something to eat. Rather than focus on what they have, they focus on what they lack. They're faced with two choices. Look at the food you have as God's gift, or look at it as not enough. And how a person views this determines what is possible. And this is a fundamental stance, I think, towards life. And what's your perspective? How do you look at it? Do you look at life from the perspective of gift? Or do you focus upon what you lack from a sense of scarcity? Do you want to be miserable in your life? Focus your vision on life from what you lack, and you'll be miserable because you won't have gratitude. All right? Looking at things from the perspective of scarcity. I'm Don Henley, the lead singer of the Eagles, wrote a song several years ago. I remember when I was in the car, I had picked up his CD, his greatest hits, and I came across this song and it blew me out of the water. It was On My Wedding Day, was the title of it. And at that point, I've never heard it sung at a wedding, but since then I've heard it sung at one wedding, okay? But I like the text. He said, on my wedding, I don't want violins or sentimental songs about thick and thin. I want a moment of silence and a moment of prayer. For the love we'll need to make it in the world out there. To want what I have, to take what I'm given with grace. For this I pray on my wedding day. Okay, to want what I have, to take what I'm given with grace. Boy, that's a spiritual stance towards living, right? Don Henley, he sees life as a gift, and he wants to accept it as it comes, knowing that God is there in the midst of it all. You know, the only piece he's missing in there is the call to share our lives then with others. But back to the gospel. Jesus sees what they have. He says, what do you have? In one gospel version, there's a little boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish. That's not enough for everybody. And the gospel from Matthew, we hear, we have only 5 loaves and 2 fish. And Jesus says, bring it to me. And then he takes it, blesses it, breaks it, and gives it. That's the fourfold action of the Eucharist, folks, okay? This is code language in the New Testament for the Eucharist. What he freely received, he freely gives. What the apostles freely received, they freely give. And that dynamic is played out, and satisfaction follows. Everyone is fed, and there are 12 baskets of fragments left over. God has provided enough. But can we trust that? Can we engage that? The spiritual disciple of Jesus does not take and hold. We gratefully receive, and then we share. And we strive to do that as a parish community at St. Thomas the Apostle. For the past several years, our parish has been moving towards becoming a tithing parish. This year, our parish commits to giving away 9% of our parish contributions to the poor. And this will be distributed to local charities as well as worldwide charities. Again, you'll find it within our bulletin in a couple of weeks. You'll be able to see where the tithing committee distributed the funds for the last quarter. And know that our tithing committee is open to your input as well. But the point is, when we can look at life from the perspective of gift, it shifts everything. Shifts the way we see life. It'll shift the way we experience life. This fourfold dynamic of taking, blessing, breaking, and giving is played out in the Eucharist for which we gather. Jesus gives himself to us, and our reception of the Eucharist clearly says, I will give myself to others. I too will be taken, blessed, broken, and poured out for others. And this dynamic is lived out in the everyday experience of our lives as parents, as children, bosses, employees, friends, strangers, and parishioners. When we live this pattern out in our lives, we are becoming Eucharist to the world. We're becoming the body and blood of Christ, broken and poured out to the world. And our world is different because of that. So with Don Henley, we pray, I want for the gift to want what I have, to take what I've been given with grace, and then share what we have been given with others. Truly brings a life of joy and peace. Together, God's people, let us now stand as we profess our common faith by praying the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now offer our prayer in the name of Jesus, who had compassion on the multitude and whose bounty feeds us all.
For the church, may we, the disciples of Jesus, distribute the bread of life to all who hunger, sharing generously with others all that the Lord so graciously shares with us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may peoples of different cultures recognize our common humanity as we sit down together at the banquet of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to trust, may we recognize that nothing can separate us from the love of God and rely upon God through all the challenges of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those in need, may seasonable weather cause the earth to yield an abundance of crops, producing nourishment for the life and the health of people everywhere. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, may we never cease to hunger and thirst for righteousness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may the sacrament of anointing and our community's compassion bring them healing and strength, especially Simi Studer, Dode Donnelly, Jack Payden, Mick Johnson, and Keith Kincaid. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the St. Thomas the Apostle parish family for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, may our faithful departed nourished on earth with living bread from heaven be raised up on the last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of abundance, in you we find nourishment that satisfies. Hear our prayers that your mercy and love might fill the earth so that all people may dwell in peace. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our preparation song is Come to the Water.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, and will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accept the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice. Make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just. It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God.
Holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come
celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is Miracle of Grace.
The body of Christ.
Miracle of Grace.
faithfulness reveal. In this covenant you seal, with your very body and your blood. Come claim your bride again, with love that cannot end. For what God joins, no one can divide. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live.
Your presence in this holy sacrament.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We do have a few announcements. Happy birthday to all of you born during the month of August. It's hard to believe August is among us already, huh? If you don't see your name listed on the insert, give Teresa a call at the church office. We'll update your records. We welcome five families who joined us during the month of July. That would be Anthony Zilch, Nancy Eakin, Valerie Johnson and her son Beckham, who's five, Amy Fuller and her children Ryan and Lauren, ages 10 and 8, and Leslie Lewis. So welcome to St. Thomas. As you read in our bulletin last week with Brian Etchart's interview, we're thoroughly sanitizing the church after both 5 p.m. Masses and the 8:30 a.m. Masses, and we could use your help. If you can help, check with Brian or one of the ushers after those Masses, or call the church office. We'd appreciate your help on that. I believe that's it. All right. Enjoy this warmer weather.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
As we go forth, let us sing All the Ends of the Earth.
Yes. No, I know.
And actually,